can I just have a moment of your time? I'm white, so I can't spit good rhyme. But I'm here to tell you about a film I think you should see. It's called The 40-Year-Old Version. It's right here. How can that be? When it's too late tonight. Hey guys, I'm sorry about that. I really am. I'm white. I can't flow. Like, I try. Avril Lavigne might be the only one who can kind of flow who's white and a girl. Anyway, welcome to another episode of Jaina Solo Says. Now, you guys are probably going, Emily, this is kind of different. Usually the stuff you review is stuff on Netflix, like TV shows and things that are usually fun, kind of fluff, stuff you're interested in. Why is this so different than your usual? Well, I'm glad you asked. As a SAG-AFTRA member, which is basically an actors' union, we get to vote on awards, and they send us different films throughout the year, or actually kind of at one specific point of the year, to, you know, for Best Actress, Best Ensemble. And this year, I'm not only getting to vote in that category as an actor from a union, I also get to choose who's going to be on the ballot, which means they're sending me things like this, the 40-year-old version. Yes, that is a play on the words, and it's very clever, I think. So this is kind of a breakaway kind of for me to kind of watch something maybe I wasn't as interested in off the bat, but it looked interesting, and I was really just impressed because the star, Rada Blank, wrote, directed, and starred in this. So as another actor, who knows, you gotta get productive to make things happen. You gotta write your own stuff. You gotta direct your own stuff. You gotta network and put up your own content. This girl knows that, and that's an accomplishment in itself. So I'm very proud of her for nothing else than getting this made. But the story is basically about a woman who's about to turn 40. I don't know if it's autobiographical. It very well could be about a woman who grows up in Harlem, and she's about to be 40. When she was younger, she was like this aspiring, gonna be really successful playwright, but something happened along the way and she never really quite made it, even though she's talented. And now she's a teacher at an inner city Harlem school teaching kids playwriting. And there's a lot of very interesting characters in this movie that I think you'll very much enjoy. Now, be warned, it is kind of slow, especially at the beginning. So for those who are really into, like, it's action-packed and let's see explosions and let's see people make out, that's not really what this film is. It's almost a documentary, if not autobiographical documentary, that is a little bit slower, but really has some cool stuff about it. It's shot very simply, but it has some great themes, like what does it mean to be an adult? What does it mean to be success? It's shot in black and white, which is really unique, and that even poses some questions. Is it shot in black and white to talk about race? I don't think so, but you could always, you know, make that argument. Is it shot in black and white to give it that sense of timelessness? Because at times it does seem like it could be something filmed from the 80s or the 90s. They make references, so you know it's modern, but it's kind of cool. For me, the reason I liked it being in black and white was it made me really focus on the character, because there was nothing to distract you. It was just the person going through the action, and that's all you had to look at. Or could it be even a metaphorical thing about things not being in black and white or many shades of gray, because that's kind of what she goes through. Choices, did she make the right ones? How did she get to where she is? So it's really cool. She does some really sick flow that I can't even try to emulate, because I'm white and I'm a girl, and she's way more talented than me, so not gonna try. But I definitely think it was worth watching. If you go into it knowing it's a little slow and that's the kind of story it is, I think you'll really enjoy it. Poses some interesting questions. There are some cool, like I said, you know, rap battle type things, which are fun, and really interesting characters. Her students are interesting, and she's got a best friend who's like her agent. They kind of grew up together, struggling with their own problems and issues. So I definitely think it was a well-done movie. Definitely deserves to be in the running for possibly, you know, awards, but I think you guys would like it. So I'm not sure. I'm sure at some point it will be on some screening thing like Netflix. Since it's quarantine time, it's got to be somewhere. But I think you should check it out. Would Jaina Solo recommend this? She would. It was kind of a surprise. I wasn't necessarily thinking I would love it. I was hoping to, because there are some, you know, really funny laugh out loud moments. And it's a different person's story. Everyone's background sometimes makes it, I think, hard to emulate and understand completely everyone else's point of view. So I'm really grateful for movies like this that kind of help open your eyes to what it's like to be a woman in Harlem, you know, a playwright, or someone just in the industry. I mean, there was a lot of stuff that I understood for that. So even that alone, but it's a cool story. So definitely check it out. And if you have any things, of course, leave them in the comments. We'll talk to you later. And thanks for tuning in to Jaina Solo Says. We'll see you next time. Letters on the sky, burning in your eyes. You love